Have they learned nothing?
Can't.
Hey guys, this is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And Netflix is making a live action Mega Man movie.
Right, because they figured, hey, if anime won't work, let's go with video games.
Oh my God. I can only hope that, Mega Man is in CGI and not, not something like this.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that. This, of course, comes days after the announcement that Cowboy Bebop was canceled because it was god-awful.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody really watched it other than to hate watch it.
Oh, it's funny. There are some people that they're starting one of those change.org petition type things to try to get it brought back for a second season. And they're like ridiculous. And they're like, well, it's gone up a whole bunch. It's like 7,000 signatures right now. And I'm like, how many times did you re-log in or different names to sign it? Because the way these people act, it would not surprise me.
Go to Kickstarter. Netflix can start kickstarting these
there you go.
Shows. Then they can see how much legitimate interest there is before they broadcast
it. I have a feeling that Cowboy Bebop is going to look like a masterpiece in comparison to this.
Yeah, for sure. So let's talk about that. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. Over 246,000, almost 247.
Woo! Oh, really? Yay!
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, we're going to make it by Christmas?
I don't know. We're trying to get to 250. At least by the end of the year, hopefully by Christmas. I don't know if it's going to happen, but we were kind of crawling there for a while, but now it seems like, I think a lot of people got unsubscribed.
Yeah. Check, make sure you're still subscribed.
Yeah, because YouTube, if you don't interact a certain way or you're the wrong kind of person, subscribe to the wrong channels or whatever the deal is, they tend to unsubscribe you. So make sure that you are still subscribed to Clownfish TV for more of this fantastic content. Anyway, this came from Kotaku. A lot of people talking about it. This appears to be a zombified version of the live-action Mega Man movie that Disney was going to make through Fox, and then they canceled it.
Well, no, so it was going to be Fox originally, but then that was one of their cancellations when they canceled a bunch of things.
Yeah, and there was some talk that maybe this one lasted a little longer than they canceled it, but they canceled a bunch of movies. That was what I didn't understand. That Disney bought Fox, and I'm still trying to figure out why they paid what they paid for, because Fox itself doesn't have a lot of IP that's really worth anything. They tried rebooting Home Alone. It was terrible.
I think there's a couple of reasons. One, because Iger didn't want to lose.
Yeah.
And he got show bit up. Two, I think it's because they wanted the rights to be able to put out the original Star Wars trilogy on
Marvel
DVD
movies,
and all that was all tied up, and like Fantastic Four and X-Men and all that was all tied into that. Was it worth that much money? No, but that's what I think they part of the reason.
Oh yeah, they're still paying for Fox, and it's there's really not much there. But the thing is that they actually had some movies in the pipeline, not Mega Man. But there are some other movies that might have actually made some money back.
It wasn't the pipeline, it was Mario.
There we go.
Yeah. Ba-dum-ching. Anyway.
They had Mouse Guard, which looked very, very good.
Actually, it did.
And they were almost done now. Not huge Noel Stevenson fans here, but they did have Nimona almost complete.
Yeah, I never understood why Nimona got picked up for a movie, but okay.
I mean, I can understand if the movie was in pre-production pulling the plug, but if you're 3/4 of the way through it, you think you'd just go ahead and
finish it.
They finished
West Side Story, and look how well that did.
Yeah,
I think
Nimona
might have had as much potential as West Side Story.
Or throw it on streaming or something.
Or put it on Disney Plus. You're looking for fodder anyway. It's almost done.
Yeah, but anyway, so yeah, this does appear to be its churning group. It does appear to be the that movie repackage for Netflix, which means the budget will probably be significantly less, which means that it's probably going to look more like this and less like this. If I had to guess, coming from Kotaku, it looks like Netflix flush off their success. Adapting Cowboy Bebop have cast their eyes toward another beloved Japanese character, Mega Man.
Just don't.
As picked up by Rockman Corner, the website for Henry Joost and Rel Shulman's production company, Supermarché, has a section on their website where they talk about upcoming projects, and among it is this bit about the Blue Bomber. Henry Rell and their in-house producer, Orly Rose Strauss, maintain
that's a lot of names.
Active development slate. Features in the works include an adaptation of Capcom's Mega Man for Churnin Entertainment and Netflix, which they wrote and are directing. Written and directed by some people you've never heard of.
Oh, my God.
Could be worse. Could be Michael Bay's Mega Man.
Hey, you know, we could all be wrong. Probably better that way. We could all be wrong. It could come out to be amazing, for all we know. I mean, it could turn out that it's this fantastic. Look, I wish we had the camera on. You should see the look he gave me. You ever see that one where it's Justin Timberlake and it's the meme and he's just staring at you? That's the look he just gave me. I'm just like, you know, hey, you never know.
You are far too trusting. I know.
Oh, I don't believe it. I was just trying to get Beth the doubt.
So geeky, because we get a lot of people are like, you're so negative about everything. Lately, she's trying to be like, hey, you know, it could be good, just to shut some of these people up. And
sometimes I honestly believe there's something. You should give things a chance. But given the track record here, I'm not holding my breath. Let's put it this way. I have very little expectations. If it's anything above, like, you know, below rock bottom, I'll be happily surprised.
Below Rockman bottom.
Uh-huh, that's right. Da-da-da-da-da. Below Rockman's bottom. I'll be happy.
Oh, that would make money. See, roll below Rockman's bottom.
Oh, my God.
The movie itself isn't the news here. Live-action Mega Man film was first reported in 2018. And again, I think this is the same movie that Disney pulled the plug on, wisely. The 2018 announcement even said that they were going to write and direct it. What's new here is the Netflix angle perhaps helped along, because Joost and Schulman made Project Power for the stream. What?
Well, here's the thing. Everybody Project jokes Power. That Netflix greenlight pretty much anything.
Yeah. This can be seen as good news, because unlike Hollywood, Netflix actually seems to be able to get stuff like this made. But which is also bad news, because the platform's recent track record with adapting stuff, The Witcher aside, has been dreadful. Well, Arcane, based off a video game, and I still have to see it. People said it's like one of the best animated series in the last 10 years.
But I'm just like, you know, I'm going to hold my breath. It's Mega Man. Game movies and shows are hard to do to begin with and not be cheesy. Sonic pulled it off. I'm sure that's why they're pushing it, because Sonic did so well. It's going to be a really fine line. Now, that doesn't mean they can't do it, but I'm not holding my breath.
Well, here's the thing, because in 2018, they had Fox money, they had, you know, they were hoping for Disney money, and they said that this adaptation was going to maintain the world of the Mega Man games while incorporating the grand production and entertainment value that Hollywood movies are known for.
Well, you know, if Netflix greenlit it, you know what's going to happen, right?
They're going to cut the
budget? They're going to cut the penis off. Mega Man's going to be it's a robot, but it's technically Mega Man. It'll be Mega just Ma'am. Mega person.
Mega Man. Oh, my God, it's Mega Man.
It'll be like some non-white woman, and it'll be like Mega Man or Mega Fam or Mega something else.
They kill Mega Man off in the first episode, and Roll takes over.
There you go. It'll be something like
they
that.
Send them to the moon like Mega Man Legends, and it's just, it's going to be Roll. The Roll show.
Just keep their fingers off a trombone, and we're okay.
Oh, my God.
They should have done a trombone movie.
Just Capcom, would you just bring trombone out for the Switch already?
Oh, they did.
No.
Oh, was it for
PS4, I think.
I don't
PS3.
Know.
Yeah, like, freaking love. Those are my favorite games, my favorite Mega Man
games.
He does.
He loves trombone. I can't tell you how much he loves trombone. But anyway, I'm just like, you know, if it's Netflix, there's always a lot of caveats lately. And I'm sure there's going to be
cadavers.
There's going to have to be a lot of changes made. Because it'll be like, well, Mega Man's a robot, but it has man in the name, which implies that it's like, okay, like He-Man. He-Man, the Masters of the Universe, would imply He-Man. But no, they just took He-Man out and called it Masters of the Universe. So they'll call it Mega Friends or something like that.
The Mega Friends. It'll be all of Dr. Wily's robots are all going to, you know, have a change of heart.
Mm-hmm. But half the ones that Roll's are listed as something man is not going to have the man in the name anymore.
Cut Ma'am.
Cut Ma'am. I have very little hope, but, you know.
Abandon all hope. I love this. Kotaku, which seems like they're kind of coming around. Well, their new editor said that they basically had to switch sides if they wanted to survive. And
I didn't say switch sides, but
they have to be a little more newsy, a little more fair. But it remains to be seen if kicking it down to Netflix is able to keep any of that promised grand production.
That's a very good
entertainment
point.
Value. I'm thinking it's going to be like Sonic, and it's going to take place in like the Midwest, and Mega Man will get transported to the Midwest or something, so we can just film it all in some small town in Canada.
Probably. Probably. You
know? Oh, my God. That was like that, the Mega Man anime. Remember that one we had? It was,
I don't remember.
I think ADV put it out. It was like a commercial for Japanese tourism. and it was only like two or three episodes.
Oh, I do remember.
Yeah, and it was like Mega Man came to Japan to and
Mega Man was animated.
Yeah, it was an anime, but it was like, and then these Japanese kids were just telling Mega Man how great Japan was.
It was. Now, see, if they were saying this is an animated show, I might be like, okay, it might not be that bad. It's animated, but they're not. It's live action. So I'm just like, oh shit.
Yeah. Oh shit. That's pretty much everybody's reaction now. Anytime.
Dude, he could talk. He was like, oh shit.
Anytime they announce any kind of adaptation of anything Japanese, anything animated, live action or otherwise, it's kind of like, oh, it's going to Netflix. Like everybody gets excited. Like, oh, they're dueling another so-and-so series. Fantastic. Oh, it's coming to Netflix.
Hey, I learned my lesson with She-Ra. But yeah. I knew months before everybody else knew, because as soon as I saw who was associated with it, I was like, oh shit, because that's exactly what I said. You can vouch. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm bringing She-Ra to Netflix. I started reading it to Neon, and I was like, and it's by Lyle Stevenson, oh shit.
Well,
and and then it came out exactly like we thought it would come out.
Tumblr cartoon confirmed, and that's exactly what we got. So we should have been surprised.
And then He-Man, oh, we're going to get Masters of the Universe, we're going to get He-Man. And then we hear from somebody, and we're like, oh shit.
It's Kevin Smith. Oh.
Oh, Cowboy Bebop. Oh.
No.
Now we're just like, Mega Man. Oh, no. Just go straight to shit. You know?
They had a Mega Man movie. It was called Astro Boy.
Astro Boy was before Mega Man, so.
Yeah. Well, that's.
I know.
But yeah, anyway, we're going to wrap this up.
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later.
Bye.